district allows biological males to access female bathrooms and locker rooms based on gender identity. One parent only learned of this happening when her daughter suddenly encountered a male student in the bathroom and phoned home traumatized. She reported her anxiety and her concern to the school counselor, who dismissed that girl and her concerns as if her feelings didn't count, as if she were in the wrong. She was told she would have to use the nurse's restroom if she felt needed privacy from a biological male student while using the restroom.
Powerful testimony there from one concerned mother in Pennsylvania. Her local school district reportedly is allowing biological males into female bathrooms. She's not the only parent who's furious and speaking out. Maria Ault, another concerned mom from the Southern Lehigh District, who pulled her daughters out of the school. She's also the founder of the Southern Lehigh Grassroots Organization. Maria, welcome. Thanks so much for coming on National Report. I know you were at that school board meeting. Tell us more about what happened and how did the school board respond?
So I was very heartbroken and disappointed. Many of the parents had spoken about the gender identity information being hidden from parents. They also spoke about the biological boys seen in the girls' bathroom. We spoke about the pornographic books that are available to our high school children, so as young as 13. And they talked more about the scoreboards and Pop-Tarts. None of this information, even though we went national, was planned to be spoken at the school board meeting. Also, when the parents spoke up at the beginning of the meeting, the superintendent speaks at afterwards. He did not bring up anything about what the parents said, nothing. And thankfully, one school board member, Jeffrey Dimmy, had questioned the superintendent based on, what was going on with hiding the gender identity information. And if this is school policy, what are they going to do moving forward? And we did find out that the draft email that the intermediate school principal had written to tell teachers to call children by their preferred name and pronoun was sent to the central office. So it was approved by the central office. So the principal had the backing of the school district to allow parents not to be informed of the student's gender identity information. Also, when the superintendent was asked, what are they going to do moving forward? He simply said, every case is different, which is suggesting that there are still cases where schools will conceal essential information about a child's social, emotional, psychological, and even physical well-being from the parents. It's now been 7 weeks, and still nothing has been done about this policy that's still in place.
Sure. Incredibly frustrating there. We were showing that email obtained by the Daily Caller. This is, again, reportedly from the principal at Lehigh in Pennsylvania telling staff and faculty, if a student shares with you their sexual identity, the fact that they're transgender, they're doing it in confidence, it's not something that you should report to parents. How does that line make you feel, Maria?
It's scary. It makes me angry because our pediatricians tell the parents and the children that they shouldn't keep secrets from the parents because they could become, you know, end up being predators. So you have people in authority who are telling the children to keep secrets. And I just don't understand. And then you're also, another major issue is that the administration is having teachers lie to parents.
appreciate you taking the time today.